my dear, like my toast on one side. You can hear it in my accent when I talk. I'm an Englishman in New York. You see me walking down Fifth Avenue, walking cane here at my side.
The only thing I ever knew cotton is ready, when the bud splits, then the bowl is star-shaped, like a big old star in the sky. Like your big old head.
Hold on, is that some cotton?
But I didn't mind, because I got to spend all day working with my daddy.
Take this picture.
Take a picture of y'all. Why don't everybody smile?
Patty, come on. I need your help in the shed. Come on.
Pop, where you taking mom?
Get back to work.
Cecil, come back here, boy. You lose your temper with them, man. This is world. We just living in it. You hear me? Now get on back to work.
Hey, you, get some of the hands help dig a hole for his paw. Hurry up! Stop crying. I'm gonna have you in the house. I'm gonna teach you how to be a houseman again.
He's coming.
Yes, sir.
And quiet when you're serving. I don't even want to hear you breathe.
Yes, ma'am.
The room should feel empty when you're in it.
It was much nicer working in the house than in the field.
Crazy, Nika, from the last.
Give me more.
I knew I had to go before he killed me, too. Part of me was scared to leave. It was the only world I ever knew.
Ma, I took Pa's watch. Ma? Ma? I'm leaving.
My mama never spoke much after that. I knew she'd miss me. But I also knew she wanted me to leave that place. And even though Miss Annabeth never said it, I knew she'd miss me too.
You know what could happen to you, son. Get up. I said get up.
I'm gonna have to lie to the boss man about that window. Good Lord, say, you ain't supposed to lie.
Sorry, sir.
Where's your ma and your pa?
Ma crazy in the head and my pa got killed.
I'll make you some ham sandwiches. Send you on your way. The boss will be here in a minute. Sundays are busy as morning.
You looking for some help? I know how to serve.
You done broke our window. They done stole our food, and now you asking for a job?
Mac and Macon, I'm a house nigga, a good one.
Don't you ever use that word, son. That's a white man's word. It's filled with hate. Didn't your father ever teach you any better? Slow down.
Son.
Look through the eyes. See what it is they want. Got it?
Strokes. I got it.
See what it is they need.
Not this way.
Anticipate.
Chitlin so much.
Just ate them good eat. The manager of Excelsior in D.C. came by yesterday. He offered me a job as a butler.
Must be paying you top dollar, huh, boss?
Yeah. I was thinking about taking it, but I don't know. I'm too old to be leaving North Carolina. I'm just fine right here.
I told him to hire you.
Just now finding my way around this hotel. Ain't ready for all them highfalutin' white people, all their fancy words.
Cecil, we got two faces. Us, and the ones that we gotta show the white folks. Now, to get up in the world, you have to make them feel non-threatened. Use that, but them fancy words that I taught you. White folks up north, they like some uppity colors.
Yeah.
I took that job up in Washington, D.C. It was the most beautiful hotel I'd ever seen.
It wasn't too presumptuous for me to have prepared a few spirits after your long journey in from Buffalo.
Best decision that court ever made was to slow this whole mess down. Nigger boys in school, white girls, we never heard of such a thing. Next thing you know, they'd be fornicating.
Yeah, but this here is different. We can start another civil war. Cecil, what do you think about niggers going to school with white children?
Be honest with you, Mr. Jenkins, I tend to not be too concerned with American or European politics.
No, but should you, Cecil? They're all criminals. Earl Warren should be shot and hanged. That dumb son of a bitch judge is trying to integrate our schools.
I think Judge Warren is going to find that quite challenging.
Damn right, Cecil. Damn right.
Never in my life that I dream I'd work in a place as fancy as this. I never dreamed my life could be so good. Gloria and I met working at the Excelsior. She was a maid at the hotel. And now her only job was raising our two boys. I made sure that they never laid eyes on a cotton field.
I gotta pee. Not today. Don't try that. Finish that homework.
Where Lou is at?
He's taking the trash out.
Working late again, huh? How's your shift?
He's working for a living.
I miss you at night, honey.
Did you say you gotta pee? Go on then. Wash your hands when you come out of that bathroom, boy.
Good morning.
Come on.
Morning, sir.
Hey, good morning, boy.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Lewis.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
And the woman whose son got killed, she's around doing speeches now. What's her name, honey?
Mamie Teal.
I remember that story just like it was yesterday, even though it's 3 years ago. Just damn grace what they did to that boy. Just for looking at a white woman. Beat him up, threw his body in the river, killed him. He wasn't older than Lewis. He was 14 at the time.
Crazy white folks down south.
Thanks, Mom.
At least we got a little better in D.C., huh?
You're still treating us bad, too.
Get on down here, Charlie. Wash your hands.
Lewis said we should stop taking a white man's shit.
Hey, wash your mouth.
Hello, Gaines residence. Yeah, hold on, Mr. Kagan. It's boss man, Dad.
What's he calling for?
When the white man call, I always assume the worst.
Yes, sir.
I would have put money on it, and I was getting laid off for something that day.
Please.
I'm Cecil Gaines. It's a pleasure to meet you.
You as well. Have a seat. Are you political, Mr. Gaines?
No, sir.
Good. We have no tolerance for politics at the White House.
How'd you find me?
I didn't. You served RD1 at the Excelsior Hotel. He oversees operations for the entire White House. You make quite an impression.
I don't recall.
Mr. Warner and myself make note of potential staff around town. Butler positions rarely open, as most stay on for 30 years or more.
I know, I was quite surprised when I got the call.
It was a surprise for me as well. As the White House maitre d', I normally hire the butlers.
Forgive me for saying this, Mr. Fellows. I certainly wouldn't want to be hired under circumstances that would make you feel uncomfortable.
Oh, really?
You need butlers that you've handpicked, men to your liking, that will fulfill your vision of a proper White House staff. These decanters are replicas of metal flasks that were found on the battlefield in Jarnac. Correct? The Italians, they know their wines. And the Irish, they certainly know how to make a great whiskey. But I believe the French have a distinct advantage when it comes to cognac. Savory?
Oh, yeah. You make a good house nigger.
Would you?
Sometimes it just be me and Faye up in here. Me, Faye, and a little Scott.
That's how you do it. You know how to throw
Say
a basket. What did you do to this potato salad?
I'll tell you what I did. I put some dill in it because I read in Woman's Day where pickles drown out the flavor and dill bring up the flavor. That's what you're tasting right now.
Okay. Yeah, I like it.
Make a difference, don't it?
It really does. You know, you must be so proud of Cecil.
You know he got that job as the White House called him. He didn't call the White House.
He's a good man. You got a good man.
She's fine. Not like this one right here. Old sourpuss. Are you still mad at me?
I got reason.
No, you don't. I told you, I went down to the number spot, played my little numbers, got me some barbecue, and then I went down. I didn't even get nothing to drink.
I'm so sick of these number spot stories, Howard. How do you expect me to believe? You was down at the number spot.
Whether you believe it or not, don't mean it ain't true.
Come on, stop.
You
want to
do this right now?
Come on, y'all. Come on.
You don't believe